Next, we're going to talk about the Chezy-Manning equation for normal flow. The Chezy-Manning equation for normal flow is the relation between the steady channel flow rate, Q, to the cross-sectional shape given by the hydraulic radius and the area, with the bottom channel slope, S0, and the roughness represented by Manning's N. The equation is going to give us the normal flow conditions when we use S0. The typical flow problem is going to be given Q, S0, N, and some channel shape, determine the depth at which we get normal flow, Y sub N. We're going to be given Q and given S0 and given N in the channel shape because rarely are we trying to actually solve for Q. The flow rate is typically determined by upstream and sometimes downstream conditions in the channel, and we're interested in, given some Q, how is the channel going to behave? Now, remember that the normal flow depth is the flow depth that satisfies the Chezy-Manning equation using S0. That doesn't necessarily mean that's the depth at which the water is actually flowing. And we'll talk later about the Chezy-Manning equation using other slopes and how that relates to what's going on upstream and downstream. A key problem for us with the Chezy-Manning equation is simply that the normal depth, or any depth, doesn't appear directly in the equations. We have the cross-sectional area, and we have the hydraulic radius, which the depth is buried within those as a function. Now, if we have simple shapes, we can simply compute the area as a function of depth, or the hydraulic radius as a function of depth. If we give an arc, half circle, or a rectangle, or a trapezoid, or a triangle, some simple geometry, we can get very simple functions. And once we've got those functions, we can plug them into the Chezy-Manning equation, and we could solve it, even if we have some extremely nonlinear and difficult equation, the solution is possible. But real river channels are more difficult because we don't have any simple relationship between area and depth or hydraulic radius and depth. So in dealing with a real river, we're going to be given Q, N, and S0, but we're going to need some relation in the river geometry. So we've got to go conduct a river survey. Typically, what we're going to have is to measure the bottom elevation relative to some z equals zero baseline at various stations across the channel. Now, of course, the z equals zero could be given as the water surface level when you're actually conducting the survey. It might be a local benchmark. In the case of a river that is emptying into the ocean, it might be sea level. There are many choices as to what the baseline is. The question here is simply making sure you have something consistent and you know what the baseline is. Given a survey, we will have a survey table. At some intervals across the river, we will have measurements of the elevation, or possibly depth. You need to know what you're dealing with, where the data comes from, and what it represents. Here's an example of a 10-meter wide river with X going across the river, and Z being the elevation above of the bottom above a baseline. Now, once you have a table of X versus Z, you should be able to use a spreadsheet to calculate the cross-sectional area as a function of the depth, to calculate the hydraulic radius as a function of the depth, and to draw a graph of the product the area and hydraulic radius to the two-thirds versus depth. Now the reason for doing that is once you've got this graph of A, R sub H to the two-thirds versus Y, you can find Y where Qn over S0 to the one-half is equal to area times hydraulic radius to the two-thirds. This is simply moving a few terms around on the Chezy-Manning equation. But once you've done this, you've just solved for y because you have the graph of a r sub h to the 2/3 versus y, and you will have your normal depth. The key point in this is that calculating a as a function of depth, r sub h as a function of depth, you're going to have to make some approximations. And that's the end of our discussion of the Chezy-Manning equation for normal flow.